Hi, this is Jacob with PCTechGuide.com, and in this video series we're covering why your computer is so slow. In the previous five videos, we've covered multiple tips on how to speed up your computer overall, because most of the time it's not just one issue, it's several issues. And through going through those several different issues, we're going to find the one that's the main problem for you. In this particular case, we're going to take a look at the browsers Firefox, Windows Explorer, as well as Chrome. If you haven't already watched the other videos, I highly recommend you do, because we have done it in a certain series for a reason. However, in the description below this video, you're going to see a link to the playlist, and that playlist is going to have all the previous five videos for this on how to speed up your computer. And as we've already talked about, you know, when your computer itself is fast, but the web browser itself is slow, you know, it could be, yes, a poor internet connection, but let's say you have a faster internet connection. Well, it could be that you don't have enough memory, which we already covered. It could be, not enough disk space, which we already covered, which is unlikely. However, a major thing that I found with a lot of browsers is going to be the extensions that people are using. And over time, you just start adding in all these extensions that are auto-loading on you in the browser, and they can actually have a very big negative effect on page load time. So first up here, we're going to take a look at Chrome. So I'm going to go to the Windows Start button. I'm sorry, to the dialog box, and we're going to go ahead and go under Settings. And under Settings, we're going to go and jump to the Extensions tab. And under the Extensions tab, we're going to see the extensions that have currently been added on to my web browser. Now, some of these, let's say it was like a coupon bar or some other toolbar, they could be slowing your system down and your web browsing experience down. So, you know, I want RoboForm there. It's something I use every day. I love the program. You know, these other ones I have in here that I use. So, you know, I'm not having any issues either. But, I would recommend you go through your extensions. And if you're not using some of the extensions, the add-ons there, I definitely would recommend you go in and you remove them. Another thing that you can do is go under Settings. And if you scroll to the very, very bottom, you're going to see Show Advanced Settings. And then scroll to the very bottom of that, you're going to see that Reset button right there at the bottom. And so what this Reset button is going to do is it's actually going to delete all the cookies. It's going to delete everything within Chrome and basically let you start fresh. Or you could uninstall it and reinstall it, and what that's going to do is it's, you know, just going to put on that fresh copy for you in case it was having issues before. Now you would have to reinstall your add-ons and your extensions and the like, but it's something that is recommended from time to time, especially if you're experiencing a lot of issues with your browser, and this will eliminate it as not being the cause of your internet being slow. Next up, we're going to hop over to Firefox. Under Firefox, it's basically the same process almost. So I'm going to go to the dialog box there. I'm going to go to add-ons, and under add-ons, here's my extensions, and I can go through and say, well, you know, do I want these? Do I not want these? You know, try to eliminate some of these. And I did find, especially with Firefox, if you have Firefox crashing on you far more than usual, it's probably an extension or a plugin. So go through and make sure that you want everything there. If you don't, just remove it. And chances are that can help, especially if it's a toolbar or something that's causing ads on your computer. So there's a lot of adware out there that gets thrown in this. And, you know, the adware shows extra ads and pop-ups and the like on your system. So that's just nothing fun. You can also go through the plugin section too as well and see if there's a plugin that you're not using anymore. So if you're like, well, you know what, I haven't used Google Talk before, I never plan on using it, why not remove it, right? And we're going to see here that my Java platform's out of date. I can actually click to update it, and that could help stabilize the browser too as well and help eliminate some of the issues overall. And this is with Internet Explorer now, and I just find it funny. Here's an ad on Google's homepage to get Chrome. It's just adorable. So I'm going to go to the dialog box there, and we're going to go ahead and go under Internet Options. Under Internet Options, oops, it's not what I wanted. I want a dialog box. I was getting ahead of myself. I want to go to Manage Add-ons. And under the Manage Add-ons, it's where you're going to see, take a close look at the toolbars and extensions, because this is the area that it can be causing you a lot of the issues. So you can go through this and just remove any plugins, any toolbars or extensions in here that are possibly slowing down your system. If you were like a browser hijacker or something, may have changed your search default, you can always go in and change that around too as well. So this is where you might be having some issues with Internet Explorer, so I'd recommend you go through there. In worst cases, what you can do is you can go ahead and just restore the defaults in it. So now you're going to the dialog box, you'd be going to Internet Options, And under In and Out Options, you're going to go to Advanced. Under Advanced, there's a reset button right here. And it's what it's going to do is it's going to restore Internet Explorer to the default settings. So if there was something internally wrong due to a configuration, and that's why pages are loading really, really slow for you, which is really, really common, especially after, let's say, a malware infection, then that should definitely help solve some of your problems there. That is it for this video. Now, like I said, this isn't necessarily your issue that you're having, but it's an issue that goes under the slow computer. And chances are, if you go through this as well as the previous 5 videos, you're going to figure out what's going on with your system. In the next video, we're going to be talking about malware and just some quick free ways of doing a quick scan on your computer just to make sure you're malware free. Because that's a major issue as to why a lot of people have either, you know, the slow internet or slow computer overall. Besides not enough memory or not enough virtual memory or the multitude of issues that we've already described in the previous videos. That's it for this video. I hope it helps. If you like the video, go ahead and hit the like button, comment, share, and the like. It's all appreciated. Thank you.